A slide wire in a potentiometer has a uniform cross-sectional area, and therefore it definitely has a uniform resistance along its length. We can control the voltage drop along the slide wire by adjusting the amount of driver current that is moving out. The process of adjusting the driver current so that it matches with the voltage drop across a certain portion of the sliding wire against a standard or a known reference source is what we are calling standardization of a potentiometer. Before we get into the details of standardization of a potentiometer circuit, let us try and remind ourselves of a few key definitions that we need to keep in mind. First of all, what is an open circuit? Remember, we said that an open circuit or a cell is said to be in an open circuit when there is no current flowing out of it. Then also, a cell is said to be in a closed circuit when some current is being drawn out of it. So in reference to a potentiometer, we look at the potential difference that is across the balance length in terms of being equivalent to a cell in either a closed circuit or a cell that is in an open circuit. We shall explore that a little bit later. For now, a potentiometer consists of a mounted resistance wire, AB, as we see. Of this wire, we already stated that it has uniform cross-sectional area. And this wire, AB, can be of any length. It can be 100 centimeters, it can be 120 centimeters, and so forth. Now, we said that the potentiometer has got what we call the primary circuit and then the secondary circuit. The secondary circuit has got a galvanometer, and the balance condition of a potentiometer is when this galvanometer is deflecting zero, or there is no deflection on the galvanometer, meaning that there is no current flowing through it. And it is at that point that the balance point along AB is obtained. When the balance point along AB is obtained, then the potential difference across the point A and the balance point is equal to the potential difference across the components in the secondary circuit. Now, when a driver cell is connected to the slide wire AB, this driver cell, it applies a uniform potential difference across the wire. So when solving problems that are involving potentiometers, it means that one key thing that we need to find first is the PD per unit length of the wire. It could be PD per centimeter or PD per meter. So in an experiment where the potential difference per unit centimeter of the wire is obtained, we describe such an experiment as an experiment that is meant to standardize or calibrate a potentiometer. In an experiment whereby we seek to find the PD per unit length of a potentiometer wire, that experiment we call it an experiment that is meant to standardize or calibrate a potentiometer. We are having a circuit here, having driver current IP moving out, and we are having a slide wire AB there. So now this AB has got a potential across it V. This wire, remember, is a wire that has got uniform cross-sectional area. So if it's having a uniform cross-sectional area, it means it's having a uniform resistance along the entire length. So for us to get the PD per unit length of that entire wire, it's going to be the PD across AB, divide that by the length of the wire. So now if the length is 100 centimeters, it means that we get the potential difference across that length, divide that by the total length of the hole, which is 100 centimeters. And so our answer will be in terms of volts per centimeter and so on. Then also, since the resistance of this whole wire is uniform throughout, then it means that we can get the resistance per unit length of this wire. And if we know the resistance per unit length of the wire, the other way of finding the PD per unit length here will be V is equal to IR, as we see here. PD per unit length, which is V, is going to be the current that is going through that, which is the current produced by the driver cell, times the resistance per unit length, which we've called R. the resistance per unit length. We get the resistance per unit length by getting the resistance of the whole wire divided by the length of the wire to get the resistance per unit length. So it means that this PD per unit length, which is V over AB, is the same as getting this over that. So those are two ways. You can either get the PD per unit length by just getting the PD across AB, divide that by the entire length, or you can multiply the current going through the wire by the resistance per unit length. And we said that the resistance per unit length is gotten by getting the resistance of the whole wire, divide that by the length of the wire. So if we are to equate this to that, like we've done here, VAB over L is equal to IP times R, we find that this, the driver current IP and the resistance per unit length, this is a constant. Those two are constant, and it's the length that may vary, and the PD across this may vary. So if you are to remove that constant, we find that our value of V, the PD across AB, is directly proportional to L. Like so, meaning that the longer the length, the higher the potential difference. The smaller the length, the smaller the potential difference. Let's try and do this example. A potentiometer wire, like we have seen here, AB, a potentiometer wire, slide wire, it's 100 centimeters long. So from A to B is 100 centimeters long. It is having a resistance of 8 ohms. So the resistance of this whole thing is 8 ohms. And is connected in series with a 3 ohm resistor, which we are seeing here, and an accumulator of EMF 2 volts. So this accumulator here has 2 volts, and it has also an internal resistance of 1 ohm. They're asking us to find the PD per unit length of the wire. For us to get the PD per unit length of this wire, we said that to get PD per unit length will be equal to, we need to find the PD across wire AB. So we get the voltage of V across wire AB and the length. Now we know the length of the wire. The length of the wire is 100 centimeters. But do we know the PD that is across this wire? So we get VAB, the PD across A and B. So VAB will be equal to current, the current that is going through that wire times R. And the current going through is the driver primary current, the IP. So IP times the resistance of AB, R. So for us to get VAB, we need the current that is going through times the resistance. Now we know the resistance of AB. The resistance, according to the question, is 8 ohms, the resistance of the wire. But we do not know the current, the primary current that is being produced by this driver circuit. So let's first find the IP. So we do some side work. It means that the V, the EMF here, V is going to be equal to the primary current we are looking for times the resistance R. If we make IP the subject of the formula, IP is going to be the potential over the resistance. That's going to be equal to, now the driver current IP is going to be equal to V, which is 2 volts. Divide that by the effective resistance in this entire primary circuit. Now the effective resistance here, we have this wire, which is 8 ohms. It is in series with a 3 ohm resistor, and this is also in series with an internal resistance of 1 ohm. So it means the effective resistance is going to be 8 plus 3 plus 1, which is going to be 2 over 12, and 2 over 12 gives us 1 over 6 amperes. So it means that the primary current that is flowing through here is 1 over 6 amperes. So if it is 1 over 6 amperes, it means that here, to find the PD across AB is going to be equal to I, the primary current going through there, times the resistance, which is 8. So it means it's going to become 1 over 6 amperes, multiply that by the resistance of the wire, which is 8. And you end up with your answer as 8 over 6, 4 over 3 volts. Now, after getting our potential difference across the wire AB, our potential difference is 4 over 3 volts. So we now have gotten a potential difference. Now what about the length of the thing? The length of the wire is 100. For us to get the PD per unit length, it is going to be this divided by the length of the wire. So it's going to be PD per unit length will be 4 over 3. Divide that by 100. And our answer shall be 4 over 300, and that is in volts per centimeter. Now that is one way of finding it. Or we can find PD per unit length by multiplying the current that is going through that wire, which is we've called IP, multiply that by the resistance per unit centimeter, or the resistance per unit length. We got our driver current IP as 1 over 6 ampere, so it's going to be 1 over 6 ampere. Multiply that by the resistance per unit length. Now we know that the resistance of this whole wire is just 8 ohms. Now if you want to find the resistance per unit length of that wire, it's going to be 8. Divide that by 100 centimeters and we get our resistance per unit length. So it's going to be multiply that by 8 over 100. And we shall still end up with, this is by 2, 3. We shall end up with 4 over 300. And that is volts per centimeter. And that is our PD per unit length of that wire. This brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. Somebody out there needs to watch this video. Don't forget to like and share. For more videos, simply subscribe to Kisembo Academy. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakurani.